Daniel and his friends obey God. Good morning, boys and girls, and happy Sunday. Today's story is taken from Daniel chapter 1, verses 1 through 16. Our focus for today is we can obey God. Boys and girls, what do you think the word obey means? Have you heard that word before? What does obey mean? You're right, following instructions. Sometimes you may hear your parents say, obey them, or you better obey the rules. That means following directions. Again, our focus for today is we can obey God. What are some ways that you can obey God?
Bible chapters for kids. The Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Obey God. Today's Bible story is about four men who obeyed God by eating foods that pleased him. We're going to look at some food pictures and decide whether or not they are healthy foods. Are you ready? Let's get started. All right, boys and girls, first set of pictures. There are two different types of food here. Which is the healthier food? Oh, you're so smart. Yes, the fruit is the healthier food. Here we have an orange and an apple. These cupcakes are not healthy. Let's get ready for our second set of pictures. All right, boys and girls, once again, which is the healthier food? The pizza or the broccoli? That is right. The broccoli is the healthier food. And the pizza is not healthy. Good job, boys and girls. Let's keep going. All right, boys and girls, let's try it again. Look carefully at these two pictures. Which is the healthier food? The burger and French fries or the baked salmon and vegetables? Correct. The baked salmon with the vegetables is the healthier food. So we're going to cross off this hamburger because that's not healthy. Which is the healthier food? The bowl of chips or the bowl of grapes? If God told you to eat the healthier food, which food item are you going to choose? Absolutely. The bowl of grapes is the healthier, oopsie. The bowl of grapes is the healthier food. We are going to put an X over the bowl of potato chips because that is not healthy. Excellent job, boys and girls, identifying the healthier food. Remember, our focus for today is we can obey God. Can you say it with me? We can obey God. One more time. We can obey God. Excellent job, boys and girls. Now let's get into our story. Daniel and some other young men were chosen to serve the king of Babylon. Daniel and three of his friends, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, loved God and wanted to obey him. Remember, obey means following God's rules. Daniel and his friends were strong. Daniel and his friends were also very smart. King Nebuchadnezzar wanted all the young men to eat the same food he ate, but Daniel knew that the king's food did not please God. Daniel wanted to please and obey God. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego wanted to please and obey God too. Daniel asked one of the king's guards to let him and his three friends eat vegetables and drink water instead of eating the king's food. They would do this for 10 days, and then the guard could see whether or not they still looked healthy. The guard agreed. For 10 days, Daniel, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego ate only vegetables and drank only water. Why did they do this? That's right, because they wanted to obey God, and God did not want them eating the food that the king was eating, because that was not pleasing to God. God was pleased that Daniel and his friends chose to obey him. After the 10 days, Daniel and his friends looked healthier than the men who ate the king's food. Daniel, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego had obeyed God. And guess what, boys and girls? We can obey God too. That's right. What was our focus for today? That's right. We can obey God. Let's say it one more time, nice and loud. We can obey God. Excellent job, boys and girls. You know what time it is. It's time for a story review. What did the king want Daniel and his friends to do? A. Eat the same food he ate. B. Watch TV. Or C. Go fishing. What did the king want Daniel and his friends to do? A. Eat the same food he ate. B. Watch TV. Or C. Go fishing. Excellent job, boys and girls. You are correct. The correct answer is A. The king wanted Daniel and his friends to eat the same food that he ate. What happened when Daniel and his friends obeyed God? A. They got weaker. Or B. God helped them have healthier bodies. What happened when Daniel and his friends obeyed God? A. They got weaker. Or B. God helped them have healthier bodies. Correct. I knew you were paying attention. Yes. God helped them have healthier bodies. Excellent job, boys and girls. Hi, boys and girls. It's Miss Candace. I truly hope you enjoyed today's lesson. Remember, our focus for the week, for the month, for the year, is we can obey God. Let's say it again. We can obey God. That means following God's rules. Okay? Sometimes it may get tough, but trust me, boys and girls, our goal is to please God. It should be to please God. And when we obey Him, we make God so happy. Don't you want to make God happy? I know I want to make Him happy. Sometimes we mess up and we don't always obey, and He'll forgive us. But we've got to try to keep that in our brains, obey God and follow God's rules. Alrighty, let's close out in prayer. Bow your heads. God in heaven, hear my prayer. Keep me in thy loving care. Be my guide in all I do. Bless all those who love me too. Amen. Boys and girls, have a wonderful, wonderful week. Remember, obey God and follow God's rules. Obey your parents and follow their rules too. That's a part of obeying God, because one of the commandments is honor thy mother and father. So when your parents tell you to do something, do it. I hope you have a wonderful, wonderful week. I miss you. Remember, Miss Candace loves you. But more importantly, God loves you. Have an awesome, blessed week.